My name is Marissa Williams. I'm the city's natural resources officer, and my duties entail managing the city's surface waters and waterways for water quality and aquatic vegetation. I'm also responsible for the environmental outreach program that the city conducts, working with citizens to help better understand their environment and ways in which they can reduce their impact and promote the city's waterways. Casselberry has some smaller waterways in comparison to some other local chains, such as the Winter Park chain, which is more known for its boating, while the Casselberry chain is more about passive recreation, really. So we have a lot of small lakes, but they're also surrounded by an urban environment. They're already mostly developed, so we have a lot of other issues that we have to combat along the way that come along with pollution in an urban environment and trying to preserve our waterways and keep them the healthiest possible while also balancing that with the residential use. My job includes a couple different components. It's pretty broad spread. I am directly in the waters and surveying water bodies on at least a monthly basis. For example, we have invasive aquatic species in our lakes, some that are exotic, such as hydrilla, where it's a species that is from Africa and Asia. So it's not native to here. And because of that, this plant doesn't have any natural enemies or natural combatants. Hydrilla specifically came through the aquarium trade. Somebody has an aquarium and that plant flourishes in that environment, but maybe it's growing too fast, or their children have grown up and they don't want to have that aquarium anymore. So instead of properly disposing of those plants, people have a tendency to dump them in canals or waterways because they don't understand the impact that that could have. So that plant just takes advantage of a nutrient-rich system where it can grow faster and with less input than a lot of our other natives. And because of that, we have to consistently make sure we're managing those invasive species at the lowest level possible. We know we can never eradicate these invaders, but we can definitely try to manage them and promote the native species that are present to try to establish a balance in our waterways. Also, a big component of my job is environmental education and outreach, because without all the work we're doing, if we can't get the entire community to come together and have individuals assist in this process, then we won't be able to make as much progress. So we have a couple different schools within the city. So South Central Middle School, for example, I've done a few programs with them where I go do outreach and speak with kids and help them understand the effect they have on the environment and little things that they can individually do or teach their parents to do along the way as well. So we can try to increase not only the ecodiversity of the location, but also improve the park itself so that visitors are able to come and enjoy and experience what a natural Florida waterway should look like.
Yeah, if y'all find any garbage too and can remove it, that's also a great help. A lot of people dump things back here.
A huge component of my job is about balance when it comes to development and expansion, because as you know, we have a lot of people that are moving to Florida, so we're trying to find a way to accommodate all of that. So the loss of natural lands can have a significant impact upon our environment and our waterways, but now the focus has really shifted towards non-point source pollution, basically a collection of small amounts of pollution throughout the basin of a waterway. Something that you do miles away from a lake, even if you don't live on one, can still have a downstream impact because of the stormwater infrastructure that's in place to convey that stormwater. So maybe one person put too much fertilizer on their yard. Somebody else decided to change the oil in their car in their driveway, and that went into the storm drain. And people don't quite understand that everything is incredibly connected, especially when it comes to surface waters. I'd love for the citizens to understand how important the waterways are to us as city staff, not just as the residents, that it's something that I'm personally very passionate about. I love my job, and I love that I'm able to work towards something that contributes towards the benefit of the citizens and also the environment. And I think I just want people to understand that everybody is connected to our surface waters in some way. Even if they're not out there fishing or boating, they still are able to drive by and appreciate those lakes in some way, or at least find a way to reduce their impact. So those who prize those water bodies so much are able to enjoy them to the best level possible. Anytime anybody's ever interested in joining us, please check out www.casselberry.org/lakes. It is our city website for lakes management, and we post when events are coming up. So I'm happy to have people come participate in Casselberry's waterways as much as possible. But what we're doing is for the citizens, not just for the environment, and we want them to be able to benefit too.